Juul suspends e-cigarette sales in Indonesia amid marketing concerns. Juul Labs Incorporated has announced that it will be halting sales in Indonesia because it is concerned that online and traditional retailers there are selling their products to young people. The tobacco market in Indonesia is largely unregulated, making the sale of high-nicotine e-cigarettes to underage customers quite common. The e-cigarette company has been criticized for its marketing to young customers in Indonesia, the Philippines, and South Korea. Juul will reportedly not sell their products in Indonesia until age restrictions in the country are more well enforced. The move is being seen as a setback for Juul, considering Indonesia is the fourth most populous nation in the world. Juul's development in Asia is important to ensure their growth outside of the US. Many have blamed Juul for causing the US youth vaping epidemic. Sources have said that the company purposely expanded into Indonesia 7 months ago, specifically because their regulatory environment is permissive. These same sources said the company was targeting people aged 19 to 35. In January 2020, Juul said that it was re-evaluating its work in South Korea, where it has had low sales. The company was also set to expand into countries such as New Zealand and the Netherlands, but these plans have been postponed. Juul has already pulled its flavored nicotine pods from US shelves because these pods attracted young customers. This is because these pods came in enticing flavors like mango, cucumber, and mint. In 2019, mint was the flavor high school vapers were reaching for the most, according to studies published in the Journal of the American Medical Association. Though these pods are no longer sold in the US, Juul has continued to market these products in places young people frequent in Indonesia. Young Indonesians can buy e-cigarettes and their pods from mall kiosks, retail shops, and even movie theaters. Attractive women working for Juul also promote these products in bars. E-cigarettes, electronic devices that heat liquid to produce an aerosol, often look like normal cigarettes or USBs. The liquid an e-cigarette heats has nicotine and other chemicals, but also flavoring. Vapers breathe in the aerosol like any other cigarette, but anyone nearby could also breathe it in once the vapor exhales it. The US Centers for Disease Control and Prevention states that one Juul pod could have as much nicotine as 20 cigarettes. What sets Juul apart from other e-cigarette manufacturers is their use of nicotine salts, which allow users to inhale higher levels of nicotine. Most young Juul users aren't even aware that e-cigarettes have nicotine. E-cigarettes are particularly harmful to kids, teens, and young adults because nicotine can harm their still developing brains. Brain development doesn't stop at the age of 18, but at the age of 25. Nicotine, an addictive drug, can damage the areas of the brain associated with mood, learning, attention, and impulse. It also affects the way connections are formed between brain cells when they learn or make new memories. Perhaps the most lasting effect of nicotine use is possible addiction to other drugs in the future.